So, good afternoon. My name is Erik Verrijken. I'm a PhD researcher at the University of Antwerp. My supervisor, Jan Stickel, is now giving a demo in Hall 5, so he can be here. I work at the Constraint Systems Laboratory, which is part of the Faculty of Applied Engineering, Electronics and ICT. And our laboratory also cooperates with Flanders MEEC, which is a strategic research and investments organization for the Flemish industry. So in our research, we are interested in localizing acoustic sources. So we do passive acoustic localization. We don't make any sound, we just analyze sounds from the environment. And these can be sounds from animals, from moving parts in machinery, vibrations, air leaks in high pressure systems, or traffic noises. And using distributed microphone arrays, we will do angle of arrival localization if the sound is in the far field, and time difference of arrival localization if the sound is in the near field. So to give an example, in the first panel, we have three microphones in a linear array, and they can use the angle of arrival localization method. So they use the time differences for the sound as well. But because they are linear array, there is a very big difference, and you cannot accurately estimate the distance of the object. So basically it becomes angle of arrival localization, and that's the cone shape that you see. In panel C at the bottom, we combine multiple of such smaller scale arrays. So they have the angle of arrival, and then we can use time difference of arrival to get the full 3D localization as shown in the last panel there. So what we introduced is the notion of a small scale versus a large scale array. So we first built those small scale arrays with a couple of microphones that are spaced relatively closely together. And then we place those around the room, and combination of multiple of these small scale nodes is what we call the large scale sensor network. So just to give a brief introduction what time difference of arrival or angle of arrival could mean. So at the bottom we have two microphones at a set distance apart. We assume the sound is in the far field, so we can make a flat wave assumption. The sound arrives. We don't know anything about the distance of the sound because the emission time is unknown to us. But when the sound arrives at microphone two, we can then calculate the extra time or the time difference it takes for the sound to arrive at microphone one. And that time difference of arrival, we can multiply with the speed of sound and we get a distance. So we now have two distances in a right angle triangle. So we have the angle that the sound has taken. But this is a 2D example. In 3D, it becomes more complicated. And the sound can come from an infinitely many angles in 3D. And we know that linear arrays cannot be used to localize an object in 3D. So we need to build planar arrays. Okay, so to do time difference of arrival, we need a larger array. We can work with more or less accurate time synchronization, depending. For the small scale arrays, we have accurate time synchronization. For the large scale arrays, we can work with less accurate time synchronization, but we still need it. We also accurately need to know the location and the orientation of the microphones or the arrays. And we are very interested in the network topology, because placing the nodes or the arrays at different locations will influence the performance of our localization mechanism. So for these small scale arrays, we have five microphones that are spaced closely together. The synchronization is near perfect because they are all sampled with the same simultaneously sampling analog to digital converter. They are synchronized near perfect. And also for the location, relatively to each other, if we have the location and orientation of one microphone, all five microphones are placed on a single PCB. So we have absolute knowledge of the location of those microphones. So we have five microphones, and then we also have an antenna, and the antenna is used for the synchronization in the large scale array, which I will explain in a second. So for the large scale array, we combine multiple of these small scale nodes and we place them around the room in the forest, some larger area. And then we can use time difference of arrival to get the sound source location. So for any two microphones, if we calculate, it's not a flat wave anymore, it's in the near field. So we get a hyperbolic surface of possible locations. And if we combine a lot of different microphones, then we can make an intersection of those hyperbolic surfaces and use that to find the location of the sound. To find the location and orientation of the subarrays, that is at the moment a tedious and error-prone job. Basically, it's manually measuring the location of the microphones or the nodes. So in the future step, we would like to go to automatic calibration of the location and the orientation of the arrays. And also synchronization is not that easy because we need a synchronization mechanism that is robust against failure of a node. It should still work. And the synchronization mechanism should be wireless, because you cannot always work in a situation where you can wire things together or if you want to set up things relatively easily. So we need a wireless and masterless mechanism. And for that, we looked at nature. So fireflies, they use a mechanism of pulse coupled oscillators. And we implemented that in previous research. So every node has a pseudo random number generator. And the keyword is pseudo because every node generates the same pseudo random numbers, so the same string of numbers. So if you can synchronize those numbers, you can embed those numbers or a part of those numbers in the data streams. Then you can later on use cross-correlation to get the timing offsets and to synchronize the different data streams that you can then use to calculate the time difference of arrival. So what we do to locate everything, first we have the small scale. So the angle of arrival, we can, for each point that we're interested in, given that we make a certain measurement, calculate the possibility, the probability that this is the point that the sound came from. So, and that's just a Bayesian estimator. For the large scale or the global localization, we do the same thing, but then we use time difference of arrival information. And finally, those two are fused together, which basically is multiplying the probabilities together and then summing them. And then we get, for all points, we get the probability that this is the actual source point, and we just use a maximum a posteriori likelihood estimator to find an estimation of the position. So the results we got from this, so these are real results. We built the array, and then we created a broadband frequency chirp. So that is the same thing that you would expect from a bat. It's a nonlinear frequency sweep from 80 to 20 kilohertz in about 2 milliseconds. And we see that we can make accurate angle of arrival estimations using a single PCB, so using the single 5-microphone array. Then in simulation, we combined multiple of those nodes. So we created 10 vocalizations of the bat, so the same vocalization as used before. And we got a couple of possibilities for the points. We did the maximum likelihood estimator, and then we traced the path that you can see in red between all the most likely positions. And that is the path that the bat should have taken, localized using 3 of those small scale nodes in large scale network. So in the future, what do we want to add to this? So we want to do iterative source tracking. So using, for example, a particle filter to get a better prediction of where the sound is going to be, to make things computationally less complex. We're all also interested in predicting the optimal placement for the nodes. Based on certain constraints, depending on the room, depending on situation, type of sound, hardware, how we should divide the microphones in large and small scale arrays, and where we can place them, and to do the automatic calibration of the large scale array position and orientation is also something we want to add.